Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks on BCTV is supported by the Berks Heritage Council.
Good evening and welcome to Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks County. I'm your host, Amanda Machik, and tonight I'm joined by Brad Kissam, volunteer at the Daniel Boone Homestead, and Heather Hicks, site manager at the Daniel Boone Homestead. Thank you both so much for joining me tonight.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Okay, so Daniel Boone hasn't been a guest on the show in years, so we're glad to have them back. Heather, can you just give us some real basic information about the homestead, where it is, what it is, all that good stuff?
Oh, absolutely. So the Daniel Boone Homestead is located in Birdsboro, and it consists of 579 acres of ground. So it's a large park. And it also includes seven historic buildings, which of course has the Boone House, which is the birthplace of Daniel Boone, the pioneer explorer extraordinaire in 1734. We also have, as I said, six other 18th century buildings, including a vertical sawmill, a blacksmith shop, a historic barn. So it's quite a lovely property with paths and walkways and lots of to enjoy.
Yeah, so recreation opportunities as well as historic.
Exactly.
Okay, cool, excellent. And I guess kind of most exciting right now, there are several capital projects going on. So the homestead is owned by the state of Pennsylvania, correct? Mm-hmm. The Pennsylvania Historic Museum Commission.
Yep.
And they're now doing several large capital projects. Do you want to tell us a little bit about those, Heather? I think you might even have some photos.
I do. So first off, to let everyone know, the Daniel Boone Homestead, the houses, the historic buildings are currently closed, as are all of the PHMC properties throughout the state.
And that's because of the COVID pandemic, correct?
Because of the COVID, correct. But the grounds do remain open. As you said earlier, we have a lovely park and recreational facilities for walking, hiking, bike riding, and those continue to be available.
Okay.
Our grounds are open to vehicle traffic from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. daily. Okay. And the park itself is accessed to pedestrians from sunrise to sunset. So there's plenty of time to come out and enjoy the parks. We also, while our buildings are closed, have a visitor's guide that's located at our visitor center outside the doors. So it's free, easy to get, and anyone can stop by, pick that up, and that will give them more information about the buildings and the historic core, as well as some of the places that they can walk around and visit while they're there. But while we are closed, we have been very busy behind the scenes, doing lots of things that when we are able to reopen, we're going to have a lot of improvements to the site that I think are going to be really exciting. So I do have some slides for you. I'll just try to slide down here and share our screens. There we go. Is that up and working?
I believe so, yes.
Okay, perfect. Well, of course, there's the homestead, as we were just talking about, and that's the Daniel Boone House. We'll talk a little bit more about some of the changes we've made with that. Capital projects. So capital projects that we have going on the site while we're closed. Perhaps the one that people who have visited the property have noticed first is our new gate, which from what I understand from Brad used to be our old gate, but is the new gate that we currently have. And we are going to be eventually doing, I think probably starting in the first week of November, a bridge replacement on the property. And as such, unfortunately, that's going to sort of stop the access point, the main entrance that we currently use. Mm-hmm. So this entrance will be open. I hope the gate was supposed to be in next week. That's what they're telling me. that this will be open and will be one of the access points to the visitor center and to our North Picnic area. The other entrance will remain open, so you can get to our bridal trailhead and a couple of other locations, but you won't be able to drive through the property completely. So depending on where you're going, there'll be two gates.
Okay.
In addition to that, we are also currently upgrading our restroom facilities. We don't have restrooms at the site. We do have a porta potty in case anyone needs it while visiting, but our restrooms are going to be made ADA compliant. And we're also getting a new sewer line put in. We used to have our own septic system, so we'll be doing some work on that. And you'll see that on the grounds as well. And we've also just recently became part of a Exeter Township Master Plan, which will increase some of the facility. Well, we'll look at creating a blueprint for how we use the site and what ways we can work with Exeter Township to increase the use of it for the community. So that's also going to be occurring. In addition to that, we have had some other exciting news recently, which will affect the Bertle at Sawmill, which I just put up. We've recently also received funds for a new capital project that will dredge the Boone Lake. Gotten very silted in over the last few years, and that will help increase the ecology of the area, as well as help us use our famous vertical sawmill. So we also had some work on that this summer, and this is one of the oldest water-powered vertical blade sawmills in PA. It was moved to the site in 1972, and we just had the flywheel replaced. So while we were doing that, I did get to set some video of it, which I'll have here, and we'll see if we can show that to you. The water wheel in action. And you can see it takes quite a bit of water, which is one of the reasons we need the lake repairs. And you can see the saw blade there up working. As we are a living history museum and do a lot of demonstrations and have a lot of crafters and stuff who are normally on site, being able to have our water wheel working again for the Bertolette Sawmill was a great treat. And I was really excited to see it work. I didn't know how interested I was in sawmills until I saw this actually in action. But then I also wanted to share another project that we've been working on at the site. And that is our repainting of the Boone House. You can see it has been white for, I guess, years. Mm-hmm. As I can say, has it been white as long as you guys have been visiting the site?
It has been white for probably at least 50 years.
Well, we're changing all of that. There was stereoscopic and polarized light microscopy.
That's a mouthful.
Yeah, I know. I'm trembling over it. That was done as part of two studies. The last one actually in 1996. And we found with those that both the east portion of the house, which is the older portion of the building, had reddish paint. And later, the west side, which is the newer side, or the deturped side, which I think is the side closer to you, so you can see most of those images, also would then have been painted to this sort of reddish brown. And eventually, the whole house was painted white sometime later, obviously, in the last 50 years at least. And these samples were taken from window frames that were original to the home. And so after doing a lot of study and looking, as I said, through through some stereoscopic instruments and stuff. We're bringing the house basically back to its original paint job. And you can see, as I said, sort of the first picture we have at the top is the white that it has been. The bottom picture below that shows the gray, which is actually the primer for the building. And you can see the red. We're still working on some windows. You can see some of the wooden boards that are up there, but you can see the house as you know, it was when Daniel Boone and family lived there. And I think it looks really great, really sort of shows off the red sandstone and sets off a really attractive vision. It's shocking maybe, but I think it looks really amazing.
It's really great that, I mean, I'm sure it wasn't necessarily on purpose, but that, you know, well, unfortunately, the house is closed because of COVID. It's kind of a happy, you know, coincidence of events here, because I can't imagine trying to do all that work if the house, you know, if it was open for tours. I mean, it'd be very disruptive. So it's kind of great that they have this time now that they can, you know, get all this work done. And then hopefully, you know, it'll be finished when things get a little bit more back to normal.
Yeah, and so it really has been very fortuitous, you know, yeah, for us to sort of have this time to really look at what we're doing. I'm going to flip to sort of our next one. So you know, during this time while we're closed, we are, of course, working behind the scenes. We have been working with our volunteers to create new digital programs. And those programs, we're working on various historic cooking, gunsmithing, talks about the different aspects of the Boone House, Daniel Boone history. So I have a whole arsenal of our volunteers who are lined up and willing to share with us all sorts of new and different information and how things work. So I think it's going to be a really exciting series that we're going to be starting on. We also, of course, if you wanted to find some of those things, there are different ways to find us. We are very active on our Instagram and Facebook, which is both at the Daniel Boone Homestead. And you can also find all of our information on our brand new website that just went up, I guess, 2 weeks ago, Brad?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yep. Right. Yep. which is www.thedanielboonehomestead. So those are three ways that you can sort of find out what we're doing and what's going on.
Heather, it's not at the Daniel Boone, it's www.thedanielboonehomestead.
Yeah, yes. Sorry, that's the website. There are others ones are at the Daniel Boone Homestead. Yes.
And is it .com, .org?
Oh, .org, I'm so sorry.
Okay, that's okay.
Yes. And so those are some of the things we're working on. We're also working on creating a new exhibit for our orientation center. I'll just take that off there. For our orientation center. And so we're currently working with several of our volunteers. We're doing some virtual volunteers who are doing some research on our, as I said, our new exhibit, which is looking at the diversity, the you know, different cultures, English Quakers, German, you know, various Presbyterians and Mennonites, and all of the different people who make the Ole Valley, you know, the special place that it is. And looking at all of these different groups coming together in the Ole Valley through the lens of the three families that lived here. And so I think that's going to really be an interesting exhibit. I've been learning a lot about it. And we have, as I said, some virtual volunteers. If anyone's interested in learning more about virtual volunteering, you can go to our website and find out about it. And we're working on different aspects of that so people can still help the homestead while they're out at their homes. And I think that's sort of what a lot of what we've got going on.
So is there a timeline for the exhibit or an estimated timeline, or that's just kind of really in the infant stages?
It is. We're in the development stages right now. Our hope is that we might be able to have something by summer or fall. A lot of that's going to depend on, you know, our research and the work that we're doing. So we'll see. But we're hoping, we think definitely by next year.
Okay. And so I just want to go back to the comments you were making about the bridge, mm-hmm. And the two different entrances. Yeah. So how will people know, which entrance to use, I guess? Because I could see people, struggling with that who aren't familiar, maybe. I mean, I'm assuming there'll be some signage up.
So there will be signage. Obviously, this will be something that we'll be putting on all of our social media as well as our website. As I said, you'll be able to access the property from either entrance. Just to be able to access all of it. So we're hoping, as I said, I've been working with the state to get signage up that if you come in one and are trying to get to the other, it should be, give you some guidance there.
So I guess the big thing probably is the Wayside Lodge. So that would be on that one, kind of that one side, mm-hmm. that people would use, hopefully once COVID's over, if that can be rented again.
Yes. And that is indeed our hopes. So yes, anyone who wanted to walk or park their areas in the Wayside Lodge or up, as I said, at the Bridle Path, would just continue to be able to access those areas. They just wouldn't be able to drive from there to the visitor center. So, hopefully we'll be able to make that clear enough to guests to come into the property.
Gotcha. Do you want to talk just a little bit about, again, I know they're not being offered right now, but about the rental program at Boone? I think you mentioned the picnic pavilions and then obviously the Wayside Lodge. Pre-COVID, I mean, those were a big, popular, especially with local Boy Scout troops.
Yes. Currently, we aren't renting those, and I do not have a date mm-hmm. that we will be reopening that to the public. It will occur, but at this point, we're not sure when that time will be. All of the rentals, when they do become available, you'll be able to get that information, as I said, through our website, through our social media. We'll certainly be doing announcements. I know I've had a lot of calls from the public. People were very interested in that. And unfortunately, there's not much I can do about it at this time. We're just kind of seeing how things develop. But once things start to settle down, hopefully we'll have a better idea. But those things are coming. So, check back, check our social media, see what's going on. And I think that's the best way to really keep in touch with that.
So are other, you obviously mentioned that all PHMC sites are closed, I guess, kind of indefinitely.
Correct.
Because of COVID, but, do you know, are other sites doing similar kind of digital programming? I'm just kind of curious, because I know there's some museums that are open. There's some museums that are like quasi open. There's some that are just kind of going ahead full steam, like nothing's wrong. And so it's just kind of interesting to me to see kind of the spectrum of, who's doing what. And obviously PHMC seems to be taking, a pretty conservative approach. I think all the county sites are also still closed, like Grings Mill and the Heritage Center and the Wagon Works. But then, like I said, there's others that are open. Some are doing events, some aren't doing events. So just kind of curious.
So the PHMC certainly has, and you can visit the PHMC website. We are creating a calendar that will have all of our digital information.
For all of them, sort of.
For all of them, yes. So many of the sites, unfortunately, we're a little bit behind. We had to build a website. We're getting ourselves restarted here. The PHMC's sites have been doing lots of visual, digital programming, lectures, talks. So they've really been working hard. And there will be, we just started to create it now, so it should be up in probably a couple of weeks, a PHMC website that will have a calendar of all the events at all the different 22 sites across the state. And you'll be able to find our events there too, once we get them up and running. And so we are working with that to get those things created. And we've just been, as I said, getting our equipment in order. We just got some new cameras. So we're learning some editing software. Not something I thought I'd need to know at this point, but we've been working on a lot of those things behind the scenes. So we should hopefully, have some great programming out for people who miss the homestead soon.
That sounds great. Brad, did you have anything you wanted to add?
Well, I just wanted to say, I've been at the homestead, and I think anybody who's ever watched this program, I've been at the homestead for over 30 years, and with a lot of different experiences and so forth. I'm very pleased with the progress that Heather has made. I have to say, she's only been at the site since March. And literally we threw her into the deep end of the pool, with the not lack of experience in the museum field, but almost no experience in or knowledge of the Daniel Boone Homestead, and has really come up to speed very quickly and taken over. And the COVID situation is almost a double-edged sword. It has limited the availability of the site to the public, but as Heather has pointed out, it has given us an opportunity to go forward with these capital projects and given her an opportunity to work on all of these things so that when we finally do get to the point that we can reopen, I think people are going to be truly amazed with the changes and the opportunities that they're going to find at the Daniel Boone Homestead. As I always do, put in a plug, for volunteers. We are always looking for volunteers. There are going to be multiple programs going on. We need volunteers for tours, craft demonstrations, special events. Heather and I have talked to some degree about what type of opening we're going to be planning for the homestead, because I'm sure there's a lot of pent-up interest and anticipation with what's going on. And I would hope that the public comes out and supports this whole new effort. And Heather has done a very, very remarkable job, given the fact that she's running a site that isn't open. But there's a lot going on, and I think the public is going to be very, very pleased with what they find.
Yeah, some of those capital projects we've been waiting on for almost 10 years.
You that some of those we've been talking about since I first started
homestead.
So it's just amazing to me that all of this came together with timing and funding. Yeah. At this point in time, so that when we do reopen, I think people are really going to be amazed at what the resource that they have in Exeter Township.
Yeah, for sure.
It is open. I mean, people, you can't get into the historic buildings, but go there, walk around the grounds, take advantage of probably one of the best historic parks in southeastern Pennsylvania. And by the way, the largest historic park in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. So take advantage of that.
For sure. I did on Saturday, right? All right. Well, thank you both so much for joining us, or joining me, I should say. And it was great to hear all about this, all these great projects, all these updates. So Heather, we'll certainly want you back. As there's more to share, and kind of the big unveiling there. Hopefully stuff continues to move along, and things get back to normal soon, and the site can reopen with all these great new improvements. So
thank you both. Follow along. Just check out, as I said, our social media or our website, and they can get all the information on it.
All right, great. Okay, well, thank you so much for joining us tonight, and we'll catch you next month. Have a great night. Bye-bye.
Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks on BCTV is supported by the Berks Heritage Council.